One type of real life application problem or word problem that we see a lot in our algebra classes are these things called motion problems. And this is definitely one topic that really gives students a lot of trouble. So let me see if I can help you understand what these motion problems look like and how we solve them. Basically, for these motion problems, you'll have some object moving at a constant speed. The speed's not going to fluctuate. It doesn't speed up. It doesn't slow down. And the problem will give you some information about either its rate of speed or how far it traveled or how long it traveled. And it turns out that these three quantities, rate, time, and distance, are related by a basic equation that we need to know. So we need to know this equation very, very well. Distance equals rate times time. So commit this guy to memory because everything dealing with these motion problems revolves around this single formula. And this formula is somewhat intuitive. I mean, if you think about it, just common sense. If we got in our car and we went 60 miles per hour, that's how fast we went, and we traveled 60 miles an hour for 2 hours, just a constant speed, then how far did we go? 60 miles per hour for 2 hours, we would have gone 120 miles. Right, and so we see how this works out. We see how these are related. 60 times 2 is 120, and miles per hour times hours, if the hours units cancel, one's in the numerator, one's in the denominator, you would get 120 miles. So distance, the distance that you travel, is equal to the rate of speed that you're traveling times how long you travel at that speed. Everything revolves around distance equals rate times time. But anyway, let's look at a real example. And like I said, students often find these very challenging, but we'll try to make it as simple as we can. So here's a typical type problem. It says Jamie drove 60 miles per hour to see her parents. Then she drove 70 miles per hour for whatever reason on her way back home. And it took her 1 hour less travel time coming back because she's driving faster. She got home quicker. And then the question is, how far does she live from her parents? Well, that's a crazy question to ask because nowhere in these sentences did it really talk about distance. It talked about rate and it talked about time, but it didn't mention how many miles away she was from her parents or from her parents back to her house. So let's see if we can solve this guy here. So one thing I highly recommend doing when you're doing a motion problem is to make a table. Tables are very, very helpful when you're doing motion problems. And in your table, you should have two situations. You should have like a going and a coming. And so we'll have a going row and a coming back row. And then we'll have columns for distance, rate, and time. Sorry if this table doesn't look perfect, but I think it'll do just fine. Okay, so we'll label this row here. We'll label this the going to her parents' house row, and we'll label this the coming back. All right, so coming back here. Okay, and then we're gonna have some columns here. The first column will make that the distance column. Then the second column will make that the rate column. And then we'll have the time column. So let's see if we can fill in any of the information about her going or coming back. Let's see. Based off of this paragraph, it says Jamie drove 60 miles per hour going to see her parents. So the rate going would be 60 miles per hour. And then I think it said coming back, it was 70 miles per hour. All right, now it did not mention anything about distance, so I'll call the distance D. I don't know what the distance is, so we'll just call it a letter. Now, here's one observation I think we can make though. Whatever the distance going to her parents' house is, then I think it's safe to assume that it would be the same distance coming back. I think that's fair to say. All right, now, I don't know how long it took her to get to her parents' house either, so I'll call that T. But what I do know is that it took her 1 hour less travel time coming back. So however long it took her T hours going, it's going to be T minus 1 hour coming back because she's driving faster. So this table will lead me to two equations. We've got distance equals 60t, and that's going, and distance equals 70 times t minus 1, that's coming back. Distance equals rate times time. Okay, so we set up our table, we made our variables and all this kind of stuff, but this has two equations and it has two unknowns, and I really would prefer one equation that's linear that only has one variable. But just think about this. Here's a key observation. If this is equal to D and this is equal to D, would it be fair to say that these two guys must be equal to each other? If they're both equal to D, then I think we can say that these two guys match each other. And so that's exactly what we're going to do. So let's set 60T equal to 70 times T minus 1. They're both equal to D, so they must be equal to each other. And that's really the key to solving these problems. So you write your table, you set up your equations, you set the D's or the terms equal to D equal to each other. And then great, awesome, check this out. We have a one variable linear equation that we're very good at solving. So we'll simplify both sides. We'll have 60T equals 70T minus 70. The same rules that we've always used still apply. You put the variables on one side and you move the constants to the other. So we'll subtract 60T from both sides. That'll give us 10T. Then we'll add 70 to the left and get 70 equals 10T. We'll divide by the variable's coefficient, which is 10. And so we get T equal to 7 hours. T is hours, T is time. All right, so let's make sure we understand the question that's being asked here. They ask us, how far does she live from her parents? Okay, so this is very, very important for word problems. You might get an answer, but we have to make sure that it's the answer that they want. Is that what they're looking for? I don't think so. They didn't want to know she lived 7 hours away. They wanted to know how far she lived from her parents, which is a distance. So knowing T, how could you find the distance that she lives away from her parents? Use either of these equations, and they should actually give you the same answer. The distance is, on one hand, 60 times 7, which is 420 miles, or you could have said the distance was equal to 70 times T minus 1, 7 minus 1, which is 6, which is also 420 miles. So it's 420 miles going to her parents, then obviously it's the same 420 miles coming back home. So we're able to find our answer here. So again, I'm totally aware that this is a difficult concept for a lot of students, but just remember that everything revolves around distance equals rate times time. You take your word problem, you make up a table with distance, rate, and time for going and coming back, or person A and person B, whatever the two scenarios are. You set up your equations and you try to write it as a single equation in terms of a single variable. Then you can solve, but just as a final remark, just make sure to answer whatever it is the question happens to be asking for.